I'm here at the Cigar Heritage Festival in Ybor City, Florida, the cigar capital of the world. It's a great place for cigar enthusiasts and aficionados to come, chill, relax, enjoy a cigar. Let's take a look. I'm here with Eric Newman, president of J.C. Newman Cigars. What role has J.C. Newman Cigars played in the event so far?
Well, we are a major sponsor of the Cigar Heritage Festival. The J.C. Newman Cigar Company started by my grandfather, J.C. Newman. When my grandfather started, there were 42,000 licensed cigar manufacturers, and we're the only one of those 42,000 cigar companies from 1895. They're still owned and operated by the founding family. We're making cigars in Tampa today.
Wally Reyes, coordinator of this event right here, is currently rolling together 2 7.5-foot pieces of this pre-rolled cigar. The objective of the end of this is to have a 100-foot rolled cigar, which would be the world record longest hand-rolled cigar. As I understand, this is the first attempt in America to make the world's longest cigar. What kind of preparation and work has gone into this?
Well, first of all, what I decided to study was how to a cigar is made. After that, I decided to make all the arrangements with the Guinness to see what the requirements based on Guinness, on size, ring gauge, and so on. Then, after we clear that up with them, I apply directly for the record, which at the present time is in Cuba, for 66 feet, 11 inches. So I decided to create my own molds and my own equipment, basically, to, you know, to create a dynamic of the cigar.
I'm here with Mayor Pam Iorio, and Pam Iorio, how do you feel this event is beneficial to the city of Tampa?
This is really a great event because it speaks to our heritage. We first made a national name for ourselves back in the 1800s because we were known as the cigar city capital of the United States and known for our wonderful Cuban cigars. And people, of course, made their living here in Ybor City and in West Tampa, working at cigar factories, creating, making these wonderful cigars that were then distributed across the country. So when we have a cigar festival, it really means something.
I was almost finished. Started to get a little bit hungry, so I looked around for some food.
I'm here with Danny Hernandez, owner of Pipo's Cafe. How long have you guys been giving quality Cuban food to the Tampa Bay area?
Actually, our parents founded our company in 1979, so we've been almost 30 years at it. Various stores, probably owned 7 or 8 stores throughout the Bay Area.
What is Pipo's probably best known calling feature of their restaurant? Like, is it the sandwich, or what is it?
I'd say by far the roast pork. Roast pork is, I mean, the time that we put into our pork makes it far. It's hard to beat. Let's put it that way.
I got the food, some cigars, and now have a greater understanding of cigar making and the hard work that is put into it.